match and invasion ruled the school.
Yeah,
it did. When I pinned Mike, totally not awesome, it was a thing of the...
Look who it is. Our old TLC running buddies, Edge and Christian. Gotta tell you guys, that was quite an impressive win last night at Invasion. I mean, it wasn't like winning the main event and all, but still, it was a nice little match.
Winning the main event? You guys totally got your asses kicked.
Yeah, are you kidding me? If it wasn't for Austin, they'd still be picking you guys up with the rest of the scraps at table. Come on.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, I tell you what, why don't we get together and have a table match, you know, for old time's sake.
Sounds good to me.
Yeah, I'm always up for dishing out a little Dudley beating.
Whoa.
Uh-huh.
Did I just hear you say the only reason we won was because of Austin? Let me tell you something. We would have won the inaugural brawl whether Austin was there or not. I can't believe you dissing me like this, man. And the Dudleys. Bubba, You gotta let me in on this one.
Oh, you're in.
Let's say you two little punks found one of your WWF buddies. Let's make this a six-man tonight. What do you think about that?
Yeah, that's fine, but let me ask you a question.
Question?
Mr. T. Any relation to Mr. T?
I didn't hear that. Tell me you didn't hear that.
No. You need to keep your mouth shut. I need to learn a little bit of respect. Yeah, this man is the WCW champion. You want to make things interesting? Let's make tonight's match a six-man tag team elimination table match. All three of your opponents gotta go through a table.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
And I pity the fool that go through a table.
Come on.
Knows we've got to win the fight.
Congratulations are in order for the WCW ECW Alliance for their victory at Invasion. I'd like to remind the Alliance, however, that victory was but one battle. I'm confident that we here in the World Wrestling Federation will win many battles and ultimately win the war.
Damn right.
However, I admit the stealing of Stone Cold Steve Austin was like dropping an atomic bomb. But then again, if it's nuclear warfare you want, it's nuclear warfare you're gonna get. Because tonight, I'm gonna drop a little bomb of my own. You see, tonight, I'm gonna do something I should have done a long time ago. Tonight, I'm going to lift the suspension of a certain WWF superstar.
Uh-oh.
Tonight I'm going to reinstate a certain WWF superstar. Tonight, I'm going to reinstate The Rock.
Yeah, all right. This is an ovation for The Rock.
I know that just because I want to reinstate The Rock, I know that doesn't necessarily mean The Rock will come back to the WWF and come back to action. Because if The Rock chooses to come back to action, he does so not because of Vince McMahon, but in spite of him. But knowing that, Rock, I've got a challenge for you, Rock. You've never backed down from a challenge before, so here goes. You know, Rock, should you decide to come back to the WF, I gotta wonder, Rock, can you still bring it? I've gotta wonder, Rock, whether or not you can still lay up the smackdown. And Rock, can you still raise the people's eyebrow, Rock? And drop the people's elbow? Can you do that, Rock? Rock, let me ask you. Rock, do you still consider yourself the people's champion? Rock, are you still worthy of being called the most electrifying man in sports entertainment today? If you are, Rock, then listen to me. Listen to me, damn it, Rock. I know you're watching us tonight. No, wait a minute. Don't listen to me. Listen, Rock. In Buffalo, New York, Rock! Rock! They're chanting your name! They're chanting your name, Rock! Can you hear it, Rock? Can you hear it? On behalf of the millions and millions of your Rock fans, Rock, come back. Come back, Rock, because once again, we want to smell what the Rock is cooking.
Vince McMahon has made the call to the Rock. The suspension has been lifted. And Rock,
listen up. You heard what Vince said. The war is still on. Tonight we need to make a statement.
Statement.
We need to continue to do it.
That's
and what
right.
better way to make a statement than Angle, Edge, and Christian all lying through tables.
Through the tables.
Wait.
Especially Kurt Angle. How dare he put his hands on Stone Cold Steve Austin?
Don't worry about it. We'll take care of him.
Damn right. I'll
we'll
be watching.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
let's do this.
Oh, yeah.
Get it ready. Do it.
It's time.
Well, here comes Kurt Angle, Edge, and Christian. Who will go through the table? We'll find out. The siege continues next. Kurt Angle, he reversed that move. It's right on his. Nick Patrick moved the table out of the way. That little good sentiment. And Kurt Angle can't believe it. And he's making hotel for Patrick. Patrick backs it up to the announce table. Give it to him, Kurt. Give it to him. Kurt Angle, he's got Nick Patrick on the table. And the ankle lock. It's locked in. It's locked in on Nick Patrick.
Say that.
It's true. He just called you a sucker.
Okay, Kurt. You want a title shot? You got it. Tonight. But let me tell you this. Your belongs to me.
First of all, Booker, my belongs to no one. You see, it's like this. after I kick the crap out of you, Booker T, tonight for the WCW title, Stone Cold, you're next. Your is mine. And I will make you a part of another alliance. The alliance of ex-champions, sadly defeated by your Olympic hero. Oh, it is true. Woo!
Tonight, I'm gonna do something I should have done a long time ago. Tonight, I'm gonna lift the suspension of a certain WWF superstar. Tonight, I'm gonna reinstate The Rock.
If you smell what The Rock is cooking.
You know, Rock, should you decide to come back to the WWF, I gotta wonder, Rock, can you still bring it? I've gotta wonder, Rock, whether or not you can still lay up the smackdown.
Rock bottom, rock bottom, rock bottom. Shane McMahon, rock bottom through the table. Ah! Rock bottom to Austin.
And Rock, can you still raise the people's eyebrow and drop the people's elbow? Can you do that, Rock?
It could be time for the most electrifying move in sports entertainment. The Rock's folded people's elbow. And this will be the people's elbow.
Rock, do you still consider yourself the people's champion?
Thunderous, overwhelming ovation for the people's champion.
Rock, are you still worthy of being called the most electrifying man in sports entertainment today?
The Rock has got a little story.
He all here in his shenanigans. The Rock didn't run over Stone Cold on the...
Do you like pie?
Yeah, I do.
Just like The Rock thought. So whether it's you, Chris Jericho, Chris Jericho's daddy, Chris Jericho's mama, Uncle Joe Jericho with the glass eye, or maybe it's Grandpa Jimmy Jack Jericho, were you just picking your nose? The Rock says, take your finger and put it in your nose. Stick it in, homie!
Listen, Rock. Once again, we want to smell what The Rock is cooking!
Listen to this, man. Listen to this crap, man. Who cares about The Rock? The Rock this, The Rock that, the hell with The Rock. The Rock ain't nothing but another sucker, man. Who cares if The Rock go back to the WWF? To hell with the WWF, to hell with The Rock.
You know, that's just the attitude we don't need, Booker. You don't need to worry about The Rock. Tonight, you need to worry about Kurt Angle.
Kurt Angle?
You need to watch that Olympic Slam. That's what you need to watch. Besides, who said The Rock's coming back to the WWF anyway? You know, he might have found a home here with the Alliance.
What's going on with that?
This message goes out to the hottest free agent in sports entertainment history. This message goes out to The Rock. Now, Rock, I know you're home, and I know you're watching this, and I know that my dad is down in Miami, Florida, and he'll be knocking on your door, begging you, Rock, saying, please go back to the World Wrestling Federation. Please go back. Now, we've all just seen some wonderful memories, Rock, and everyone is pumped up for the return of The Rock this Monday night. But, Rock, it is my responsibility to show you yet some other memories that you have had here in the WWF.
I have a problem with the people's champion. You're not the people's champion, you're the people's chump.
Rock, you're gonna have the shortest reign of any WWF champion in history.
Destroy The Rock!
Vince McMahon took
the World Wrestling Federation Championship from The Rock, shattered The Rock's dreams of becoming WWF Champion, drive him out of the World Wrestling Federation completely. You're the people's chump.
McMahon just screwed The Rock.
Rock, there is no chance in hell you'll ever again be the World Wrestling Federation Champion. No chance in hell. You're not the people's champion.
McMahon just cracked Rock's skull with a steel tear.
You're the people's chump. I have indefinitely suspended The Rock. I have a problem with the people's champion. I have indefinitely suspended The Rock from WWF action. You're not the people's champion. You're the people's chump.
Now, Rock, the choice is yours, and we will all find out the answer this Monday night. But, Rock, you can either accept Vince's invitation to go back to the World Wrestling Federation, and we all know how that will end up. Or, Rock, you can take Vince's invitation, shine it up real nice, turn that some sideways, and stick it straight up Vince's candy ass! Rock, the choice is yours. See you this Monday night in Philadelphia.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Are you ready?
I was born ready.
Are you sure you're ready?
I'm ready.
This is his hometown, Booker. This is your chance to make a name for yourself. Right here in Pittsburgh, you beat the Olympic gold medalist, Kurt Angle.
Who cares about his hometown? Who cares about his damn fans?
Because you can embarrass him right here. Look at this. That's gold, brother. That's gold. Don't lose the gold.
I am the WCW champ.
Are you the champ?
I am the WCW champ.
Are you going to embarrass him?
I am the WCW champ.
His mama's out there.
Who cares about his mom?
You going to hurt her feelings?
You better hurt her if she get in the ring.
Can you do it? Can you do it?
I'm going to do it.
Can you dig it? Out there and you whip that man's ass.
The end is here! The end is now! Hey, wait a minute! Wait a minute! There's a down! Stone Cold! That damn paranoid rattlesnake! Stone Cold! Stone Cold! Oh, no! Austin, he must have sent the prince! What a master plan! Austin created a false distraction! All the lumberings have emptied them! They're all over the building, but there's no one here to help Kurt! A stunner to Kurt Angle, just like an invasion!
WrestleMania, Fort Worth, Texas. Rock, do you remember what happened there? I know you do. You were in a steel cage match, and you were screwed by that man right there. That man. Rocky, let me take you back to the night before. WrestleMania itself, WrestleMania. Houston Astrodome, almost 70,000 people going wild, millions all over the world. And Rock, they all watched that man right there screw you. And talking about WrestleMania, Rock, let me go back to one farther. Let me go back to the year prior WrestleMania. What happened there, Rock? Is it all coming back to you? That's right. You were screwed once again by that man right there. And Rock, if you do decide for some reason, you come back to the World Wrestling Federation, that's what's in store for you night after night after night. Rock, you will be screwed over and over and over again by that man right there.
All right, a second. Quite frankly, Rock, an overwhelming chant for the returning Rock. I must admit, Shane's view of the facts are somewhat distorted, yet at the same time, somewhat accurate. I've made a lot of really good business decisions in the past, and I've made some that were bad decisions. I can state unequivocally, it was a very bad decision for me to back Stone Cold Steve Austin at your expense. I admit it, a very bad decision. I should have known better. After all, Austin is a rattlesnake. It was a matter of time before he turned and bit me, because that's what snakes do. But I'm not standing here tonight offering you an apology, Rock, for the past, because that would be empty-handed to a man like you. I won't do that. At the same time, Rock, as I stand here before you, hoping that you come back to the World Wrestling Federation. But if you do, I never have any intention, Rock, of ever screwing you again. At the same time, I'm looking in your eye, Rock. I can't say it would never happen again. If it was the right thing to do for business, I might do it. But at least, Rock, at least you're getting a truthful response. And if nothing else, Rock, it's at least the devil that you know as compared to the devils you don't.
Wow. Good point.
Now, Rock, if you come back to the World Wrestling Federation, I know I'm gonna attempt to earn your respect and your trust each and every day. And you may never trust me again. And I'm all right with that, Rock. But at least, Rock, trust yourself. And Rock, trust each and every one of these people. Your future, Rock, is with these people and the World Wrestling Federation.
You're damn right it is.
Excuse me. The future is with these people, all right, but not with the World Wrestling Federation. No, Rock. Hear me out. Stephanie has said that the WWF is dying. It's dying, Rock. The Alliance is where the cool factor is. The Alliance is a progressive company, and Rock, obviously, you are a progressive man. Rock, you're a superstar. That transcends it all. The biggest icon in the business. The biggest free agent in sports entertainment history. So, Rock, I extend my hand. And your future is here, Make your decision here. Your future is with the Alliance.
I feel it, JR. The Rock will listen to reason. The Rock will join the Alliance.
Back off. Listen then, Ron. Come on now. Make the right decision, okay? Listen to the voice of reason. Listen to the voice of experience. Give the people what they want.
To know why The Rock chose the WWF over the Alliance. The world wants to know The Rock's explanation as to why he's in the WWF and not the Alliance. Well, it's really simple, because The Rock says this: The Rock didn't come back to the WWF for Vince McMahon, because The Rock owes Vince McMahon absolutely nothing. Vince McMahon didn't make The Rock. Hell, The Rock didn't even make The Rock. Made The Rock. And being in Washington, D.C., just like the Constitution says, we the people for the people. Now, that's tall people, short people, fat people, skinny people, people who make Slurpees, people who have herpes. All the people who get rid of household pests and all the people who have enormous breasts. Aside, The Rock was born in the WWF, and The Rock will never leave the WWF. And as God is The Rock's witness, The Rock will forever be the people's champion. Now, The Rock will admit there is one more reason why The Rock came back to the WWF.
payback. Payback to a certain bald-headed, guitar-strumming, biggest piece of Texas trailer park trash called Stone Cold Steve Austin. So Austin, The Rock knows that Kurt Angle came out and he challenged you to a match at SummerSlam, no problem. Because you see, The Rock has waited 4 long months. He doesn't want to wait 4 more seconds. So Austin, why don't you come out and hug The Rock?
You think you could just waltz back in here and challenge Stone Cold Steve Austin? Oh, hell no. You're not in the man's league. More importantly, you're not in my league. In fact, you look out and walk down there right now and kick your pretty ass up. Who am I? I'm the WCW champion, sucker.
You're the WCW champion, sucker. What's more important, The Rock doesn't believe he caught your name.
What's my name? Hell, my name is Booker.
It doesn't matter what your name is!
Tell you what, it should matter because I came out here tonight to challenge your punk ass to a match at SummerSlam. What do you think about that, Rocky?
You're going to SummerSlam?
Oh yeah, I'll be there.
What are you gonna be there for? What, does somebody need to park their car outside the building?
You didn't say that. Tell me you did not just say that.
Oh, The Rock did say that. And The Rock says this. You want to come out here and run your mouth at The Rock on The Rock Show SmackDown? Well, The Rock says this. Booker C, Booker G, T, hell, it doesn't matter what your name is. Why don't you walk down the ramp? We don't wait for SummerSlam. The Rock will whip your candy ass all over Washington, D.C.
All my life, I've gotten exactly what I want. Exactly what I wanted. And Rock, by you choosing to go with the World Wrestling Federation, Rock, and not going with the Alliance. You know what, Rock? I don't want you in the Alliance anymore. We don't want you. But Rock, what I do want is I want a piece of The Rock. I want a piece of your ass, Rock.
Take the flattering chant directed at Shane McMahon.
And the only reason why, Rock, that Booker T is not walking down the people's ramp and coming into the people's ring and kicking your candy ass all over the place is for one reason, because I want something. And Rock, Shane O'Mac wants to go one-on-one with the Great One.
What?
Shane, easy now.
This Monday night, Rock, Raw is War. Shane O'Mac and you in a street fight. What do you think about that?
A street fight?
What does Rock think about that? Between you wanting a piece of The Rock's ass and your friend being the champion sucker, The Rock just wants to know what in the hell kind of alliance you're running over there. Shane McMahon, you and The Rock. Monday Night Raw, street fight. One-on-one with the Great One, The Rock has no problem with that. Because this Monday night, The Rock is gonna whoop your candy ass. And one way or the other, The Rock is gonna get his payback on Stone Cold Steve Austin's candy ass. And as you can tell, The Rock sets out to get exactly what he wants. With all the electricity surrounding us, as you now know, The Rock is back. Is cooking.
Where you been, man? But it's not important. It doesn't matter. We're up next, you understand? Undertaker just arrived here. Wait, he said, okay, wait, let's make this a title match. No way are we making
this. I accepted this challenge, Shane.
Why'd you do that?
Why? Because I have to bury this dead man once and for all. I have to put him away. Why? Because I have something to prove to The Rock and the millions of his damn fans. This sucker dissed me, man. He said he didn't know my name. He had the audacity not to know Booker T. I'm the five-time WCW champion.
What a champion.
This sucker dissed me. I'm going to take him out of the game. I'm going to take the Undertaker out tonight. It starts tonight, Shane.
I'm feeling that.
Give me some.
You understand that? Give me some payback?
Payback.
I just wish The Rock was still here. You know why?
Why is that?
I take The Rock out right now,
sir,
this Monday night.
About. That's what I'm
you
talking
take
about.
You take Taker out tonight.
Let's take this sucker
one
out tonight.
Time.
Take this sucker out next week, and we're done with him. Let's get out of here.
Let's do this. Let's do this.
The Rock is still here, listening intently to Shane, and we meet Monday Night on Raw in a street fight. But up next, The Undertaker goes one-on-one with the Alliance's Booker T, and now this match is for the WCW title.
The Undertaker's down, the WCW champion in control, the referee down as well. Tim White didn't see a thing.
I need an Alliance referee out here. Let's get old Nick Patrick, my buddy. Where's he at?
He was chokeslammed by Kane earlier tonight.
I forgot about that. All right. And another typical WWF maneuver. Let's beat up referees.
Undertaker into the ring. Here's a typical Alliance maneuver. Let's use a steel chair to win a matchup. Wait a minute. Here comes The Rock. The bomb of ball. The Rock. The Rock into the ring. Shot to Booker T.
No. Job, Shane!
Shane McMahon with a steel chair to The Rock!
Shane just shut down The Rock with a steel chair right across his pretty face!
And this is what it's gonna be like in that street fight on Raw Monday night between Shane
dominate
and The Rock!
Dominate him! Beat him!
Wait a minute, Undertaker in the ring! Into the cover! Can he do it? Can the Undertaker do it? Right here!
Book on! No!
There's two!
No!
And wait a minute, Shane McMahon!
This is great! Shane O'Mac controlling the whole thing!
Shane McMahon just saved the WCW title for Booker T! And The Undertaker's living!
Oh man, take is coming! Get Shane, go! Split!
Undertaker in pursuit of Shane McMahon into the ring! Shane just tossed that WCW title to Booker T, the champion!
And now at the Grizzle!
And it's shot to the face!
Tremendous!
The goal by Booker T! And what's that Shane? What's that Shane? Fight on Raw Monday night.
Stop him!
The Bomb of Ball!
Stop him!
Stop!
Hey, 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 what's going down?
Hi, can I help you?
You sure can, sweetheart. Booker T, 5-time WCW champion, and I'm here to audition for your movie.
I see. Well, I'll just need you to fill out these forms.
Oh, yes.
I'm sorry, what did you say your name is again?
My name is Booker.
It doesn't matter what your name is! Your buddy was so hysterical when The Rock did it to you last week on SmackDown.
Hey! This ain't about The Rock. The only reason I'm here is to prove that I'm a bigger star than The Rock will ever be. This acting stuff is overrated. Hell, how hard can it be? I'm the Booker Man. I am the Booker Man.
Did you say you were the Booger Man? I don't think I saw that one. I mean, was that a foreign film?
Just give me the damn forms.
Does that say what I think it does?
That's what it says.
Hey, are you the director? I'm Booker T, 5-time WCW champion, and I'm here to audition for your movie.
Right, I'm Rob Schrader.
I knew that.
The director of the film. Quick question, Booker T.
Question.
It says here under formal acting experience, you wrote none, but how much damn experience did The Rock have when he made that dumbass mummy movie?
Yeah, that's right. What's the problem with that?
Okay, listen, Booker. You do realize this story is about an 18th century British aristocrat who discovers his true love after being given a magic locket.
Yeah, I'm down with that. Of course I knew that. I will be, let me see that. Lord Johnston Chatterberry III. How you like that? This part is mine, man. Hark, tis this locket will secure my love so true. Camera pans as Chatterberry takes the locket and enters the castle. I trust this.
Booker, those are stage directions. You're not supposed to read those.
What are you saying, man? Too stupid to get this? I'm too stupid to play this part or something?
No,
you calling me dumb or something?
No one's
man?
Saying that. Lisa, can you come in here? Booker, this is Lisa. She'll be playing Lady Bianca.
What up?
Why don't we take it from the next scene?
Five-time WCW champion. But your fine self. Let's do this.
Oh, Lord Chatterberry. This night has been so enchanting. I trust you brought my locket.
Yeah, I brought your locket, sucker!
Did you just call her sucker?
Yeah. It's called improvisation. Don't you know anything, man?
My mistake, Booker T.
Oh, wait. Booker T?
Yeah, 5-time WCW champ.
Are you related to Mr. T?
I want her ass fired.
Rock. Now, I know we haven't always seen eye to eye. And I don't like you. And I know that you don't like me. But the fact is...
Whoa!
Whoa. Why don't you like The Rock? Well, usually you're pretty mean to me. I mean, I remember this one time when you said you were gonna shove my gold medal straight up.
The most important thing is The Rock is back. Let's let bygones be bygones. Clean slate. And we could start by you telling The Rock exactly why you're in his locker room.
All right. Well, I know you had this match with Shane McMahon, a street fight tonight. And I've had my own experiences with Shane McMahon in street fights. And I have a little secret weapon that's gonna guarantee you a win tonight. Something that I used against Shane McMahon, against every guy I ever fought. Now, I don't know why I'm doing this. Probably because you and I are on the same team. But here it goes.
What in the blue hell is that?
It's got calcium. It helps you build strong bones. And above all, it's delicious.
Let The Rock understand this. You come walking in The Rock's locker room without knocking. And of all the things you could offer The Rock, first night back, Raw's War, live in front of millions and millions of Rock's fans, you offer The Rock a glass of milk?
Yeah.
Well, you know what The Rock is gonna do, Kurt, with that glass of milk? He's gonna take the glass of milk, he's gonna turn it sideways, and you know what The Rock is gonna do? Some of the best damn milk The Rock has ever had.
Oh, I know. I've had it.
The Rock appreciates that.
Hey, you're welcome.
Thank you. But, for future references, Kurt, the next time you bring The Rock a glass of milk, and it's this delicious, bring The Rock some pie.
I got you.
Huh?
I got you.
You got The Rock?
Oh, I'll bring you a lot of milk. And I know this place that makes great apple pie. I'm with you, Rock. I'll bring it next time. It's true. I'll do it for you. Yeah.
Thanks anyway. Thanks for the milk.
Good luck.
My love for thee is pure and true. But alas, I must depart. Farewell, Lord Chatterberry. Farewell.
Lady Bianca, wait. I have something I must give you. Chatterberry reacheth into his pocket and pulled out the locket. As the music swells, camera zoom in on Bianca's reaction.
Okay, what the hell is wrong with this guy? This is like the fifth time he's done this.
Booker. I don't think this is working out. Maybe this isn't the right project for you.
Right project? Let me tell you something, man. This project sucks. This whole movie sucks. I don't need this, man. I'm more talented than The Rock will ever be.
Oh, wait a minute. Did you just say The Rock? Do you know him?
I don't believe this. Know him. Not only do I know him, I plan on taking his ass out at SummerSlam. Now, can you dig that, baby?
Wait, you're taking him to SummerSlam? Are you like his chauffeur? Oh, no. You're his butler. This is The Rock's butler.
She didn't say that. Tell me she did not just say that.
It's just because I'm a really big fan of his and I would love his autograph. Wait, for me or my mom?
This is it. Look here. You people here don't recognize talent. To hell with all of you. I'm the Booker Man. The Booker Man. Now, can you dig that?
Do you know if The Rock can do an English accent?
All right, that's it. Hollywood, this is going to...
Word.
Shane McMahon! Or should The Rock say gladiator? Shane The Rock says this. You might have been born with a silver spoon in your mouth, but tonight, you're going home with The Rock's black boots shoved right up your ass. If you smell what The Rock is cooking.
Booker T telling Shane McMahon something. How's that submitted?
The five-time WCW champion Booker T laying the smackdown on The Rock.
Now wait a second here. He's helpless and this match is over. This match is over. Booker T is telling Shane McMahon to go upstairs.
And Shane's going up. And no one goes up like Shane O'Mac.
Oh my God, The Rock can't defend himself. The Rock is down here and he can't defend himself. My God, don't do it.
Shane O'Mac off the top.
I would say the sucker is the man who got his kicked last Monday night. I'd say the sucker is the man who has not 5-time WCW champion. I'd say the sucker is the man who's scared and jealous of Booker T.
Please.
Rock, I would say you're the sucker, sucker. But you know what? Rock, if you feel any different about what I said, all you have to do is accept my challenge at SummerSlam, and I will give you everything you got coming to you. First thing would be,
chance of the Rock filling the Staples Center in LA.
You can hear him, Cole. They gotta rub it in. We can hear them. Chance for the Rock.
Like I said, the first thing will be the scissor kick.
Bam.
Booyah! The second thing is gonna be the spin-a-rooney. One, two, three. Now can you dig that, sucker?
Booker T, you wanna go one-on-one with the great one at SummerSlam? Well, congratulations, because you're going one-on-one with the great one at SummerSlam.
The Rock's accepted the challenge, and Rock's buddy Arnold Schwarzenegger loves it.
But before The Rock faces you at SummerSlam, he has one question. What in the blue hell is a spin-a-rooney? Who came up with the spin-a-rooney? Fisher Price? And just so The Rock understands this, so The Rock's thinking is clear, The Rock has got the sharpshooter, the Rock Bottom, and the People's Elbow. And you've got the spin-a-rooney, the dipsy doodle, and the supper succotash. You see, Booker T, you can get involved in the Rock Street Fight on Monday night. You can come and challenge The Rock on the Rock Show SmackDown to a match at SummerSlam. You can come all the way out here to Hollywood just to get your hair done by Whoopi Goldberg.
Get it?
Yeah, I get it.
But Booker T, all jokes aside, there is nothing, and The Rock means nothing, that's gonna stop The Rock from giving the 5-time WCW champion a 5-star whooping all over SummerSlam. But now we have one problem. At this moment, The Rock is not interested in SummerSlam. The Rock's interest is tonight.
Uh-oh.
I know you want the Booker Man real bad.
So I tell you this, why don't you walk down that so-called people's ramp? Step into the people's ring and face Shane O'Mac and Booker T in a handicap match right now.
A handicap match?
That's what the man said. Rock's so big and bad and everybody loves him. Just bring it.
Allow The Rock to think for 1 second.
Oh, wait a minute. Here we go.
Big mistake.
The Rock on his way down the ramp.
Big mistake, Cole.
Heading toward the ring, toward Booker T and Shane McMahon.
Big mistake. I promise you. Big mistake.
This could be Shane's at SummerSlam. Rock going one-on-one with Booker T, but Rock's got to watch himself here tonight.
Hey, Rock, get in the ring. Get your butt kicked.
Rock's got to remember what happened to him on Raw this past Monday night. Left line outside the ring by Booker T and Shane McMahon.
Remember, Shane on the book.
There's the equalizer. Rock's got an equalizer. And Booker T could be on top of the people's champion. Booker T stopping the hell out of the Rock.
Looks like he's getting his people's butt whooped, don't it?
The WCW champion who meets the Rock 10 days at SummerSlam on pay-per-view is beating the hell out of the Rock.
Look at the intensity of Booker T.
And now Shane McMahon, the intensity as well, as Booker T and Shane continue to hammer away at the Rock. Booker T is an animal.
Booker T's a monster. Shane O'Mac's the best damn player coach in the game.
Well, perhaps the Rock, a little kick to the face, spinning kick to the face of the Rock.
Pretty face just got busted.
Well, the Rock may have bit off more than he could chew. Walking into this, he walked into a trap, and Booker T pounded away on the people's champion. The Rock almost lifeless in the ring.
Booker T just wearing out the Rock's jaw, and I'm digging it, sucker.
Well, Booker T just asked Shane McMahon to hold the Rock, and Booker T with a steel chair in hand. Shane to Monday Night Raw.
Booker!
The Rock! Spinebuster on the chair! The Rock hammering away at Booker T and Shane McMahon from behind!
Oh, Shane O'Mac on the attack! Oh no, the Rock's coming back!
And here comes The Rock, right hands by the People's Champion! And another big right hand! Shane over the top rope! The Rock is clear of the ring!
I don't like the look of this, Cole! The Rock don't look too happy!
The Rock outside the ring. Wait a minute.
What the hell?
The hell is this all about?
Oh, I'm out of here.
Get the hell out of here, too.
He's up to
The Rock destroying the announce table. The Brahma Bull, the People's Champion, fire in his eyes, is tearing apart the announce table at ringside.
Yeah, and that's called for, right? For what?
And Shane McMahon is trying to hightail it. Skedaddle over the barricade. And The Rock in the People. Rock in the People has got Shane. And Shane over the hard way.
Shane fair call. Rock fighters with Booker, not Shane.
And Rock with a big clothesline, knocking Shane down. And Shane from his seat in agony, in pain. And look at the fire in the eyes of the Brahma Bull.
Booker T's out on the ramp.
The co-owner of the Alliance and the WWF's Rock. And what the hell is Rock going to do here?
I don't know what he's going to do, but I don't like the look of it.
Rock pulling Shane McMahon, a lifeless Shane, to his feet on the announce table. Oh no, this can't be good for Shane. This can't be good. The Rock.
No!
Rock bottom, Rock bottom, Rock bottom. Team Briggs says, let the bodies hit the floor.
Stephanie, I know what it's like to be disrespected. Believe me. But it pained me to sit back there and listen to this punk-ass sucker dissing you like that. You see, Jericho, this woman right here is all natural. You see, Jericho, you see, Jericho, Damn, you looking fine, Stephanie.
Yeah, she's as pure as he drinks.
You been taking your vitamins, girl?
And Triple H is the only driver.
You see, Jericho, this you seem to be the expert on women with your long, pretty blonde hair. I hear there's an opening for a new Backstreet Boy. Maybe you ought to check it out.
Oh boy, was that ever a good one. Well, I hear there's an opening on the new A-Team reunion special. Maybe you should...
He didn't say that.
Maybe you should check that out, Mr. T!
Tell me he didn't say that, JR.
You didn't say that.
That's what I just said.
Tell me he did not just say that.
I just said Mr. T.
See, Rhino, I can't wait to SummerSlam. Because after you beat that pretty boy, I face The Rock.
For the WCW title this Sunday. That's what you're gonna do.
And I'm gonna take his punk ass straight to school.
He's intimidated. He's intimidated by Booker and Rhino. The man knows to keep quiet.
You just said that you were gonna take The Rock straight to school. School. Well, The Rock could just imagine what you were like in high school. The oldest 27-year-old senior the world has ever seen. Meep, meep. Going to class, getting inside the classroom, teacher up on the blackboard. Okay, class, what is 2 + 2? Do you know, Booker? Okay, I know the answer to that. 2 + 2? Thomas Jefferson, sucker. Obviously, Booker T, you're a highly intelligent man. But not as intelligent as your boss, Shane McMahon. He obviously had more intelligence than you because he didn't want to come out here tonight after what The Rock did to him on SmackDown. Rock bottom right through the table.
That's a fact.
But The Rock guesses that old saying is true. Booker T, hair done by Whoopi, Shane McMahon, still a pussy.
Wait a second, Rock. That was a good one, but you're forgetting one half of the family. I mean, look what's standing in the ring right now. You've got a man beast and a hose beast. I mean, we're dealing with the gore and the whore!
Shut up!
That's enough!
Shut up!
That is enough! Enough! These two clowns are gonna get their asses kicked by the Alliance! And I'm promising you that!
Oh, The Rock understands this one, Chris. This is a little rhyming contest between you and The Rock. Well, The Rock has got one better than that. Oh yeah, The Rock has got one better than that. Here's a little rhyme. Here's Booker T and Shane, the punk ass sucker, and the silver spoon motherfucker.
No, that's enough! That's enough! Rock! Jericho! If you want Booker T and Rhino so bad, Booker, wait! If they want you two so bad, why wait till SummerSlam?
Yeah, why wait?
My thoughts exactly!
Why don't you, Rock?
You know, I think that's just what Y2J and The Rock wanted. Thank you, Stephanie. You're the best. I mean best. It's gonna be The Rock, Y2J, against Booker T and Rhino tonight in front of millions of people, live, Raw is War. You see, The Rock and Chris Jericho, we're gonna take you two on a little geography lesson. Yeah, we're gonna go to France, we're gonna go to China, we're gonna go to Russia, but don't worry, we get in trouble, we could use Stephanie McMahon's breast as a flotation device, but... It doesn't matter where we go. Around the world once, some places twice, the fact remains, we will wind up right back here whooping your candy asses all over Chicago.
Shane, if there was no Booker T, there wouldn't be no Rock. Everything the Rock has, he stole it from Booker T.
It's true. I know that for a fact.
The people's elbow. Hell, what a joke. Everybody know that the real most electrifying move in sports entertainment is the spin-a-rooty.
Here it comes, Michael. Man!
The spin-a-rooty. Woo!
What talent this man possesses.
And the Rock Bottom Everybody knows that the cheap imitation of the move that took him out on Raw, the bookend. And more importantly, everybody knows that Booker T has these most beautiful hairstyle in the business today.
I know I have hair envy every time he comes out here.
You should.
And as far as that little comment The Rock made last Monday about Booker T in school, well, let me tell you something. The Booker man was a straight-A honor roll student. Mega cum laude, can you dig it, sucker?
What? Mega.
And as far as Sunday night, SummerSlam, nothing. And the book means nothing. It's gonna stop the real people's champ from walking down the people's ramp and laying the smack it down on The Rock's candy ass.
He's so articulate. What a great interview this man is. Where does he get his stuff?
If you smell what the book is cooking.
Booker T, congratulations. Last Monday night, you gave The Rock not one, but two rock bottoms. The very last one on a steel chair. And Booker T, The Rock has also heard that you have another name for the move. Another name in which you call the bookend. But you see, Booker T, The Rock wants to make sure that you perfectly understand that the name of the move isn't called the bookend. No, 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 no. The Rock wants you to understand what the name of the move is called, because it's the very same move that you're gonna get this Sunday at SummerSlam. The very same move you're gonna hate this Sunday at SummerSlam. And the very same move that's gonna allow The Rock to walk out a winner this Sunday at SummerSlam. You see, Booker T, The Rock knows you're here. He's heard about you running your mouth. And The Rock also knows that you consider yourself an honor roll student. Well, why don't you come out and allow The Rock the honor of whooping your candy ass all over Salt Lake City?
The Rock is calling out Booker T! Wait a minute. Hey, that's Alliance member Sean Stasiak.
Booker, Shane. Guys, I'm sorry to interrupt, but I've been just told by Stone Cold Steve Austin himself that I've got a ton of potential. And I know if just given the opportunity, I would do something that these people would never forget. So what do you say, Booker? Let me go down there right now and make an example of that Booker T wannabe. I know I can do it. Just give me that chance.
Booker T! The Rock has no time to listen to this crap.
Wait a minute! Sean Stasiak rushing the ring! He said he was gonna make an example of The Rock, and here we go! Stasiak and Rock! The bell is rung! An impromptu match is underway!
But Stasiak's going toe-to-toe with The Rock!
What is Sean Stasiak trying to prove here? The Rock, look out! Stasiak in trouble! Rock bottom! Rock bottom! Rock bottom! To Stasiak! The cover by The Rock! That was for you!
Now, before The Rock was so rudely interrupted, Booker T, Rock just wants to say this. The Rock is issuing you a 3-day warning. 3 days from this day forward, you're gonna walk the face of the earth. 3 nights from this night forward, from this Sunday night, The Rock is gonna walk in SummerSlam. The Rock is gonna walk out WCW champion. But you see, Booker T, that's Sunday. The Rock called you out here because he's got a great idea. The Rock has got a fantastic idea. For tonight.
Tonight? What?
And it's an idea that even you can understand. Live, first time ever, on The Rock Show, live on SmackDown. The Rock is challenging you to a match, first time ever, lights out match.
A lights out match? What?
Lights out match, Booker T. The rules are very simple. There are no rules. No alliance, no WWF, no rules. Booker T and The Rock, lights out.
No way. Uh-uh. Ain't happening. Booker T's not going to get lured into this. He's too smart for that.
No rules. No alliance. No WWF. All right, sucker. You're on.
You and The Rock. Booker T, no alliance, no WWF. No WWF title on the line. Just you and The Rock. Booker T, turn out the lights. Because the party is over. If you smell now what The Rock is cooking.
Vacation. Booker T up high. Wait a minute. It's Shane.
Shane McMahon with a low blow. A low blow to The Rock. It's Shane talking